Standing before the Iron Throne, Dany steps forward and kisses the man she loves, a perfect kiss. Their eyes closed, his hand behind her head, her hand on his cheek. Dany's eyes open suddenly as she draws a sharp breath. John's eyes open as well, already filling with tears. For a moment, neither moves, as if moving will make this real. We see John with his hand still on the hilt of the dagger he just lodged in Dany's heart. Her strength leaves her and she collapses to the marble. He keeps her in his arms and she falls, kneeling down to the floor beside her. He looks down at what he's done, terrible and necessary. End of Game of Thrones. Woo.
On his way down, they fall, clattering around him as he hits the concrete floor. He shakes his head clear and slowly pulls himself into a sitting position. Hank looms over him.
It was you all along, you. You drove into traffic to keep me away from that laundry. And that call I got telling me Marie was in the hospital, that was on Pinkman. You had my cell number.
That call I got.
Hank.
Marie was in the hospital.
You killed 10 witnesses to save your sorry ass. You bombed a nursing home.
Heisenberg, you lame two-faced sack of shit. Hank, just hold on.
Heisenberg.
I don't know where this is coming from.
Holy Christ, I'm going to put you under the jail.
Just take a breath. Please. Wild accusations.
Under the jail.
They could destroy our family.
Just listen to yourself. These wild accusations, they could destroy our family.
Damn, and for what? Shit about family.
Like you give a shit.
I didn't want to do this in front of everybody.
He hands Frank a small jewel box. Inside, Frank finds a gold ring with an Italian coin on top.
Only 3 people in the world have one of these. And only one of them is Irish.
I have one. Angelo. One. And now you.
I don't know what to say.
Put it on. Let's see if it fits.
Frank slips on the ring. It fits.
There's one other thing. I'm sorry to do this to you on your special night, but I can't wait. It just got out of hand
with our friend again. And some people having serious problems with him. And it's at a point where you're going to have to talk to him and tell him. It's what it is.
You got to talk to him for his sake. Tell him what it is.
Oscar. Yeah. I think I'm gay.
Kevin, why would you say that?
I'm getting so emotional.
Listen to me. I did not kill Mike. Last I saw him, he had his bag, the one that I brought for him. He got into his car and drove away.
And for all I know, he is alive.
As far as I know, he is alive and well. And if he comes back, and he doesn't understand why I had to do what I did, well then, that will be on me.
Jesse,
I need you to believe this.